Welcome to Chapter 4 of the DIY Demo. If you have not seen Chapter 1, please watch it so that you fully understand the demonstration and are aware of the safety precautions involved. In order to pause the video in between steps, press the button of the video. Press it again in order to restart it. In this demo, we are going to test our current transformer. Take out the CT, the cables, the relay and the C-Probe 1 current clamp. Please use the red cables whenever connecting to P1 or S1, and black cables whenever connecting to P2 or S2. Connect the red and black cables that are attached to the CT to the relay's CT inputs. During this demo, the CT and the relay will simulate part of a substation. Connect I out to the CT's primary side using the high current cables and clamps. Connect the red cable to the P1 and the black one to P2. Connect IN1 to the CT's secondary side. The connection should look like this. Configure IN1 as a voltage input by pressing the IN1 key and subsequently pressing the analog, voltage, AC, auto, and accurate keys. Please verify that the CT's secondary loop is closed by injecting 1 amp for a few seconds. Now you should be able to see a few millivolts at IN1. If the value is above 1 volt, please stop the test and check the wiring, as the CT's secondary side might be open. Now we are ready to test the polarity. Please set a timeout of 2 seconds and then inject 100 amps into the CT. The phase angle displayed at IN1 is what we need to focus on now. It should be between 0 degrees and 90 degrees. The CT's polarity is correct. If it was between minus 90 degrees and minus 180 degrees, then the polarity would be reversed. Next, we are going to test the CT's ratio. Connect the current clamp to IN2. Set the clamp to 100 millivolts per amp and apply it to one of the secondary wires leading to the relay. Configure IN2 as a current input by pressing the IN2 key and subsequently pressing the analog, clamp, 100 millivolts per amp, AC, auto, and accurate keys. Since a ratio cannot be measured directly, we need to define it as a calculated value based on our current measurements. We can do that by pressing the calculated measurement key, switching it on, and subsequently setting I out and IN2 to be our operands. Ratio to 5 will be our calculation setting. We are doing that since our demo CT has a 300 to 5 rating. Return to quick and activate the device in order to output 100 amps for 2 seconds. Now we can see the actual ratio. Finally, we want to measure the burden. In order to do that, we need to change from primary injection to secondary injection in order to allow higher secondary currents to flow for a longer period of time. It is convenient to use thinner cables for this. Now configure the calculated measurement to apparent power by using the IN1 voltage as operand 1 and the IN2 current as operand 2. Since one operand is a current and the other is a voltage, we can select apparent power S for our calculation. In the Quick app, set a nominal secondary current of 5 amps. Now inject these 5 amps for 2 seconds. The measurement shows the secondary burden of the CT. We're done. Please disconnect everything and put the CT, the current clamp, and the relay back into the case.